Always hit fast. Reactive acts fast.
BT, JP, Tam, sit here with you. It's lovely. It's going to be below seasonal here with you. It's lovely. It's going to be below seasonal this week.
Yep.
But, you know, some people love that.
Yes.
I'm fine with that. We good with below seasonal?
No, but I'll take it. It's fine.
Tam is out of below seasonal.
Seasonal or above.
All right. Mm-hmm. Okay. Welcome back to BT. What's your favorite game show on TV ever?
Price is Right's right
up there for me.
Yeah.
Mine's an old school one called Press Your Luck, just because people would be like, no whammies.
And then one guy cheated and they shut the show down, right?
Yeah. There's one a new guy... version. Do you watch the new one?
I can't.
No.
It's so good.
Really?
It's so good with Elizabeth Banks. Tune in.
There's only
one. It's good.
There's only one Press Your Luck.
It's good.
Wheel of Fortune, though, is right up there for a lot of people. And breaking news over the last 24 hours, Pat Sajak says after season 41 coming up, that's it. He is walking away from the show. Pat last night on Twitter bought a couple of vowels and wrote this. Well, the time has come. I've decided that our 41st season, which begins in September, will be my last. It's been a wonderful ride, and I'll have more to say in the coming months. I don't need to hear more than that. I'm fine. We don't need a press conference or anything. Many thanks to you all. If nothing else, it'll keep the clickbait sites busy. I think Pat has a very inflated sense of self.
Ooh,
he's 76, took the helm back in 1981.
Jeez.
With Vanna White, we don't know who's going to replace him. The show gets 26 million. Look at this, Viz.
Wow.
The show gets 26 million viewers a week. Forbes says my guy Pat Sajak makes $15 million a year. He makes more than, like, Connor McDavid. And Vanna White makes $10 million. So Vanna White makes more than most NHLers on top of that.
Mm-hmm.
So just a sense of what it would be like, Tammy, I'll start with you, to be a part of Wheel of Fortune or a game show where it's the same thing basically every day. Is that the kind of job that would fulfill you?
So I have a confession. I watch Wheel of Fortune and Jeopardy every night. I'm a 90-year-old lady who likes to watch what I like to watch. And I, watching it, I'm okay with it. So being a part of it, I'd be okay with it. For $15 million, I would so be okay with it.
Yeah.
Sure, I would do that every day. And remember, they probably only shoot that in like 5 months, like over the course of five months,
the
whole season. So you're making, what is that? Per 3 million $3 million per month you're making? Okay. I'll do the same thing over and over again. You want me to do this? I'll do it. Sure. No problem. I'm in.
I don't know. I don't know if I could just... it depends on whose job, though. If it was Vanna White, I don't know if I could do the...
I couldn't do either.
I could, yeah. But the Pat I can do.
You could do Pat?
I think I'd
but
be...
But Pat doesn't do anything.
I'd be rude to people.
At least if you're hosting.
I'd be
That's
horrible
what he does.
To people.
I'd pay to see you host.
Yeah.
I would be rude.
You would be like an assassin hosting a game show.
Oh, that totally.
You would take people down when
I love
it was
that
no
kind
one's
of
business.
Stuff.
But I'm with you. I couldn't, like, to me, the repetitive nature of...
Yes.
I know it's a lot of money. Please halt the tweets. I understand it's a lot of money. But over and over and over again, like, I've seen enough movies where they have the fake game show host, and before they go out there, they just down a bottle of bourbon just to get through the show.
Hi, like, welcome to another edition of I Don't Want to Be Here.
Yes. It's one of the... It's one of those.
But I'm gonna solve the puzzle. I'm dead inside.
You're that. Yes, JP. That's exactly. I'm with you. But I don't think that's like some stereotype.
No,
I think with
I
at some point in people's lives, he's been hosting that show since '81. Vanna White's been on that show since '81.
Yeah.
You think they've all been good days?
Yeah.
You
no.
think one day they woke up and say, I don't want to do any more vowels.
Yeah.
I'm out.
But they wake up in their like 12 bedroom mansion or on a yacht somewhere thinking, you know what, this is pretty good.
But that doesn't always guarantee that you're going to be happy.
No, right? It doesn't. I mean,
like, you're just sitting in their bed just counting letters, you know what I mean, trying to fall asleep. It's like,
you'll be counting numbers, too.
But, I mean, if you're working on, you know, Wheel of Fortune, you're counting letters. Or, well, I don't know if you, you know that.
You know, I know what you mean. I know what you mean. But, yeah, that's a long time. And you think about, like, Alex Trebek. He hosted Jeopardy for so many years. But at least with Jeopardy, there
it's
was
different.
A little bit. Yeah, it's different.
The questions are different.
Yeah.
And it challenges your intellect, which I like
it
watching
does.
Jeopardy.
Yeah.
Not, like God rest Alex Trebek's soul, didn't mm-hmm. challenge. Like, he read the questions and we moved on, right? Like,
yeah, but I mean, he was still trying to guess in his head what they were.
And he knew the answer. He had to know the answer to say correct, right?
We have to.
He has them all. He has them. He doesn't have to guess.
Would you host a game show for like 40 years at breakfast television on Twitter? I know it sounds like it's amazing. It can try. It might take you places that you don't want to go to. I know. Thank you for saying that. I thought it was on an island.
I'd be the most bitter host. But it would be great.
John Paul for the host of all the game shows.
Yes.
Let's get it
going.
Think
of one for you.
All right, we're going to take a break. Coming up at the bottom of the clock, Tammy will have a live update from Miami. Former U.S. President Donald Trump will be officially charged with 37 counts federally. That is going to be a scene. More BT coming up after this. Also, Frank is letting you know about the Princess Margaret Cottage home. It's a beautiful, beautiful spot on Lake Buckhorn. Oh, look at it. More BT coming up.